I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help.
Begin this evening with the Pledge of Allegiance and some patriotic music. And let y'all get set up. Y'all tell us when you're ready. Mr. Square, if you would come up to the microphone and just tell us who we got with us. And are we playing the national anthem?
Yes, sir, we're going to play the national anthem.
All right, so I'm going to, I'll actually start us off with the Pledge of Allegiance, and then if you can let us know who's going to be playing for us. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Yeah, if you'll tell us.
Good evening. I'll be quick. My name's James Square.
Mr. Square, speak into the microphone.
Okay.
We're broadcasting on television.
Turn this way into the mic. I was just going to use my outdoor band director's voice, but we'll use the mic here. All right, thank you, Mr. Duncan. Thank you, everybody. Tonight, for our national anthem, we have a special group. We have Mr. Matthew Jays, the band director at LaRonger High School. We also have Mr. Desmond Vanette, band director at Ameet High School, Roseland. And where else are you? At Ameet Westside. So he's at a lot of campuses. We also have with us at the D.C. Reeves Elementary School, we have from Elementary Music, Mr. Richard Otan. We also have two of our honored All-State players with our group tonight. We have on baritone saxophone, we have Abigail Morris. And on the euphonium, we also have Nicholas Smith. And I'll be playing euphonium along with them. So this is the beginning of a faculty low brass group that we would like to start here in Tangipahoa Parish to keep our music teachers active as playing musicians so we can model for our students. So if you would honor our country, our state, our parish by joining us in singing while we play the Star Spangled Banner.
Square, who was that entertaining us on the way in? If you, would you tell?
On the way in, I'm glad you asked.
Yeah, hey.
The group that you heard on the way serenading us in, that is the Champ Cooper School Beginning Band. It's a mixture of 6th, 7th, and 8th graders. We're so very happy. talking about getting banned for going for about 12 years.
Go back to the microphone. We're going to talk about that a little more.
Okay, sure.
Not that we all have a lot to do already.
Band director's voice here.
But yeah,
as I was saying, you know, it's been a work that we've been trying to do for like the last conversations about the last 12 years, trying to refashion and rebuild our music programs here in Tangipahoa Parish, because there's so much value in music education, not just in what you hear in instrumental music, but it has to start in elementary. And it continues as we grow, not just through school, but through life. So the group that you heard outside, that was the upstart of the Champ Cooper School Band. And I'm very proud and honored to be the director there. And when you talk about starting a program from scratch, we have Champ Cooper. We've got some things here in the immediate area at Roseland, at Westside, Sumner. Where else do we have them? Yes, in the Hammond area. We've got Greenville Park, West Side, and the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade school at Hammond East Side. All of us are planting those seeds to build our band programs. Our next part that we want to do is start expanding into the vocal music education, because everybody has that first instrument, your voice. Right, Mr. Teddy? And we also have to get them started as youngsters in elementary. When kids start to move around and get mobile, they will sing, they will draw, they will dance. So we've got to reach our young people in the arts very early in age and grow them not just through our school program, but we want them to continue through life, Mr. Duncan.
That's right.
And I know we've had that conversation.
And I want to thank you, Mr. Square, because there's been a lot of work and conversation over the last few years to kind of develop that strategic approach and that strategic plan, and it's nice to see that today we get to see a little bit of the fruits of all of that work. And of course, you've been an instrumental part in helping to make all of that happen.
So, no pun intended.
Yeah. There you go. Thank you very much. Great to see
Mr.
you.
Mr. Duncan.
Back.
Mr. Teddy, someone asked me, one of my students, I said, Mr. Square, how many years have you been teaching? And it hit me. They were in a camp that I started teaching before I graduated school, so it's coming up on 40 years. Been a while. Mm-hmm. But this is how it keeps me looking 35. Okay. Thank y'all.
Mr. Another legend band director in our audience right now, I want to recognize him, Mr. Dan King. He was Independence High School band director for many years, and maybe we can get you back into this program and helping out and get you out of retirement.
All right. Next item on our agenda is to consider the approval of board minutes from our April 9th, 2024 meeting. Is there a motion to adopt the minutes as presented?
Move.
Motion is made by Mr. Toler.
Second.
Seconded by Ms. Dominguez. Is there any objection to the motion? Hearing no objection, the motion is agreed to and the minutes are adopted. All right, so we'll next move to our awards and recognitions portion of our agenda. The first item under that section is to recognize our all-state choir and band students, and I believe Ms. Fusell, are you going to be doing that?
I'm going to call back up Ms. Stephanie Robertson and Mr. James Square. But while they're coming forward, Ms. Stilley was calling me when the music was playing out there. And I reminded her that the music was here tonight. And she said to please convey at the start of our recognitions that she is actually at a magnet schools conference, but she's really sad she's not here tonight because this is the favorite night to recognize all the students. So congratulations on behalf of Ms. Tilly to all of you who are going to be recognized tonight, because we have a lot of recognitions. I'm going to ask Ms. Stephanie Robertson, who actually serves as a district director for our LMEA, and Mr. Square, who of course you've heard tonight talk about our music programs, and they're going to recognize our students who have been All-State Choir and All-State Band. If y'all two will come forward tonight, Mr. Duncan is going to assist.
That's a powerful.
Well, thank you. It's really nice for these students to be recognized and honored. LMEA All-State is comprised of the top music students in the state of Louisiana. They go through two auditions in order to be selected. One is just a general audition for everybody, and then the top, like, 20 or less students get selected to the second round, and then they pick the top from there to All-State. So it's really exciting for these students to be selected to the All-State choirs. And I'm going to throw this in because one of my choir students, it's not LMEA, there's a different organization, but she not only made it into LMEA All-State Choir, she made it into an ACDA All-State Choir, and then she was in a regional All-State Choir of the Southern Region in Louisville, Kentucky, that she was in February, and she's only a freshman. So it's really exciting. So I don't have the list. All right, so we'll start with the choir students. There's two All-State choirs that students can be selected to. First, we have the treble All-State choir, and so students who were selected to the treble All-State choir are Anaya Lane from Hammond High. And Ashlyn Trahan from Ponchatoula High. And then our mixed All-State choir participants are Leah Lopez from Ponchatoula High. And Leah's the one that was the ACDA regional All-State. And then Emily Villars from Ponchatoula High.
Good morning, Ms. Robertson.
Good morning, Mr. Slater.
We talked together for several years, and that was our greeting, even if it was 3 o'clock and the first time we had a chance to actually say hello. On the instrumental side of music education, there are a number of ensembles that students can audition for in the state of Louisiana. They include the jazz band. There's also a guitar ensemble. We have a new handbells choir that's coming in this fall. We're expanding the All-State scene to include middle school. We haven't seen the audition materials yet, but we're sure they will be quite a challenge, and we hope that we have some of our Tangipahoa students eligible for that. And also in the band area, we have what we call the concert and the symphonic bands. Once again, there are two rounds of very strenuous auditions, and it is quite an honor to play in the All-State bands with students across all of Louisiana. We're very proud to have not only from District 9 LMEA, but especially here from Tangipahoa, Ponchatoula High School. We have on euphonium Mr. Nicholas Smith. Oh, let's talk about freshmen again, Miss Robertson. On one of the toughest instruments to make the All-State bands, it's the saxophone. And some students will try out on alto, tenor, and baritone saxophone. Three different voices, three separate auditions. And we are so proud of this young lady from Ponchatoula High School, and we hope that she's opened the door for other kids from Tangipahoa Parish. As a freshman making the All-State concert band, please welcome Miss Abigail Morris.
Folks from Hammond High, it looks like. So we're going to go ahead and ask Mr. Vining to come up because we have a lot of our athletes here. So
You want to do the Amy Magnets girls basketball team?
Coach Pierre, would you come forward, please? Good evening, everyone. I'm Mark Vining, coordinator of athletics for Tangipahoa Parish School System. I'd like to call Ms. Pierre to come forward, or Coach Pierre, I'm sorry. Coach Pierre is the head basketball coach at Amy High School Magnet, and she's going to recognize or call up her coaches, and then also she's going to recognize and call up her student athletes.
First of all, I would like to thank you for having us here. Coach Sharika Muse, if you would stand, come forward. I think my other assistant coach was Coach Daisy Brown, but I think she's sick. She just left the urgent care. She haven't made it here yet. My statistician, Ja'Kayla Brown. Athletic trainer, Ms. Danielle Blackwell. In absence of Mr. Ryan Mayo, he's not here as well. We have one freshman. I will start by class. Freshman Janae Harris. Sophomore Destiny Tate. Sophomore Kayla Tofield. Sophomore Renee Harris. Sophomore Toriana Dawson. Sophomore Anaya Williams. Junior class, Skylar Hickerson. Katicia Jenkins. Alexia Moore. Of course, my senior class is the last class, and this is a very special class. I will start off with first Sanaya Addison. Sanaya Addison will be attending Delgado Community College with basketball and academic. Ajay Collins. Kalia Tobias. Brianna Tillman. Brianna Tillman will also be attending Delgado College for academics and basketball scholarship. Mirka Irving. Mirka Irving is a honorable mention All-State. She will also be attending Delgado Community College for academic and athletic scholarship. Haley Broomfield. Haley Broomfield is second team All-State. She will be attending Mississippi Gulf Coast for academic all and athletic scholarship. I also want to add that Mirka Irving and Haley Broomfield were also chosen as our East All-Stars.
Before we go any further, with the parents of these student athletes, please stand.
Our principal is out on business with the school, but we would like for Ms. Janice Hammonds to come forward, please, our assistant principal.
Okay, presented to Amy High Magnet School girls basketball in recognition for winning the state championship runner-up 2024 by the Tangipahoa Parish School Board 2024. Also, I'd like to add this is their second year that they were runner-ups, and if you missed the game, it was a wonderful game. The girls fought to the bitter end, and they are a great example for Tangipahoa Parish School System. Thank you so much, Coach.
Next up, we're going to recognize our Ponchatoula High boys basketball team, I believe, as the state champions.
Yeah.
Coach Taylor, come forward, please. And I thought I saw Dr. Caminita. Is Dr. Caminita here? Did she leave? Come on up, Dr. Caminita.
Caminita.
All right. I'd like to thank the school board and all you in attendance for recognizing all of the student athletes and our team as well. And congratulations, Coach Pierre. You had a heck of a run. Great job doing what you're doing. I'm going to start with our young guy, sophomore Joe Kelly, Joseph Kelly. All right, juniors, I have Reese Elzey. Let's go, CJ Brazil. Corey Jackson. Caleb Sieberly. Cody Alnaziat. Jarvis LeBee. Reese Thorne. Ethan Pelche. Ashton Campbell. And Tristan Jackson. My senior class, Noah Farina, Todd Bodie, Jeremiah Lewis, Taj Jackson, and Alan Graves. This senior class, I don't know if we realize, they started when COVID, their freshman year was our COVID year, so there was a lot of adjustment for the last 4 years. And back-to-back state champs, I think that's a pretty good testament to how they persevered. I guess I got to recognize the guys that are my main people, support system, my assistant coaches, Melvin Hewland, Danny Dunn, Gary Polk, and Ewan Thorne.
And as Coach said, this is back to back. And that's very, very unusual. That is very hard. And it's a tribute to these coaches and these players. The hard work that they've done, their record was 30-4 this year. 30-4. So it says, presented to Ponchatoula High School boys basketball in recognition for winning the 2024 state championship by the Tangipahoa Parish School System 2024. Give them a round of applause, please. Also, please, would the parents of these athletes stand up, please? Parents of these athletes, please stand.
Go away.
Congratulations.
Next up is to recognize our 2024 Academic All-State recipients, which Mr. Vining's going to help us with that.
I have the privilege of recognizing an outstanding group of student athletes. These young adults are an amazing product of their family, their school, and Tangipahoa Parish school system. They have each reached the ultimate goal of student athlete by maintaining a perfect 4.0 grade average for 8 semesters. Not just high school, senior year, but 9th through 12th, 8 semesters, while participating in an LHSAA athletic program. As I call their name, I ask that they come forward to receive their certificate. And as they come forward with their family members, please stand to be recognized. First, from Jewel Sumner High School for baseball, Clinton Sharkey. From Ponchatoula High School for basketball, Morgan Watkins. From Hammond High School Magnet for basketball, Andrew Wilson. From Ponchatoula High School for football, Gavin Gill. From Ponchatoula High School for football, Grant Gill. From Ponchatoula High School for soccer, Emily Addison. From Ponchatoula High School for softball, Sarah Eula. I think Ponchatoula is playing in a playoff game tonight. So that is why Sarah was not able to make it. So be thinking about them. They are playing tonight. Second round, they got a bye in the first round. They're playing in the second round for the high school softball girls. So. Next, from Ponchatoula High School, for softball and volleyball, Laney Polk. From Hammond High School, for swimming, Linus Summerfield. And from Hammond High School, for girls outdoor track and volleyball, Jordan Wilkes.
Mr. Duncan, while we're waiting, I'd like to, I see one of my old friends in the audience, Mr. Teddy Forrest, a former Ponchatoula High Band Director. Please stand up, Mr. Teddy, be recognized tonight. Thank you for coming. We appreciate you and all you did all those years. I happened to see your head in there and I recognized you, so thank you.
We have one more state champion to recognize, Mr. Vining.
We do have one more state champion to recognize, and this young man was the boys' long jump in Division II. He jumped 22 feet, 2.5 inches in the state indoor meet. He is from Amy High School Magnet. That is Brandon Coleman. Just to let you know, Brandon is just a junior, so he'll contend for indoor next year, and also I'm sure he's competing the first weekend in May. I know they'll have district and regionals, but I have faith in him that he'll be participating at LSU in the first weekend in May.
And the family members also of our academic all-stars. I don't know if we got to get them. They did stand up for you. No, I'm talking about the, okay, we did get them. All right, next and finally, we are going to recognize our 2024 senior superlatives. We think that maybe we're missing some Hammond High participants, but if they come in, we will bring them up when they get here and make sure that we recognize them. Hopefully they are on their way, okay? But you have an ETA on them? Oh, yeah. Do you not monitor them on Life 360 like we do for everybody? Okay. All right, we're going to go ahead and we'll save the Hammond High people for last.
We sure will. So we're going to recognize, as Mr. Duncan said, our senior superlatives. And just so you know, as most of you probably know, the ACT is a nationally recognized exam. It's an indicator of college readiness. It's not the only indicator, but it is one of the indicators for college readiness. The highest ACT score would be a 36. The national average is a 21. We recognize the range from 27 to 36 because in the state of Louisiana, the highest tier of our TOPS is a 27 to a 36. So that's how we came up with our senior superlative group, just so you know. So before we go by school, I do just want to give you the overview because you kind of lose focus as they come up one by one. And if they give, you know, we say their score, but just so you know the whole picture. 13 of our seniors scored a 27. 13 scored a 28. 5 scored a 29. 11 scored a 30. 5 scored a 32. 3 scored a 33, 1 scored a 34, 1 a 35, and we have one perfect 36 score. So as we're going to go by school, when we call the school name and the child comes forward, I would ask that the faculty, staff, and the families of that child stand. And then Ms. Cindy, we'll do a picture after every school and do that because there will be so many up here. So our first school, Amy High Magnet School, Nicholas Rainey, 27.
Thank you.
faculty, anybody from Amy High, faculty, family, students, y'all make sure you stand. That's your people. All right, Hammond High, we're going to pause on you. We're going to go to LaRonja High School, where we have Andrew Dreer with the score of 30. Jaden Jackson, 27. Madison Nicole with a score of 30. Ponchatoula High School, got a little list here, Ponchatoula High. Emily Addison, 28. Zachariah Bear, 28, and accepted. And he's also been accepted into West Point. Landon Bardalis, 30. Avery Brumfield, 27. L. Carter. Huh? Ethan Cochran, 32. Catherine Diaz, 28. Catherine Dickens, 28. Aiden Dixon, 35. Luke Fletcher, 27. Grant Gill, 30. Connor Gleason, 30. Deanna Gilliatt, 27. Joshua Hidalgo, 29. Gregory Hubbard, 33. Ren Mate, 32. Wyatt Mate, 32. Isaac Phillips, 36. Perfect score. Also a national merit finalist. Nathaniel Sanchez, 30. Nicholas Smith, 29. Summer Stevens, 27. Liam Tallow, 34. Also a national merit finalist. Taylor Thibodeau, 27. Ava Thon, 27. Daniel Wall, 32. Morgan Watkins, 28.
Mr. Piazza, did you know it went up to 36? I did not.
Trent said he scored a 37.
Good job.
Anybody, I guess y'all been standing. I've been looking at the paper, make sure I don't lose my spot. I hope y'all been standing like you're supposed to. Sumner High School, we have Sebastian Costas, 27. Joan Pan, 28. Jolene Reeland, 28. And Elise Terrebonne, 27.
Folks just came in. These are engineering students, so they're great at timing, obviously. The engineering team for Hammond High is actually on their way, I believe, to the World Championship in Houston or something like that. Very proud of them, and I think y'all are leaving tonight. They're They snuck in just in time to see some of their classmates get recognized, and then they're heading out and hopefully to win us some more awards like they always do. They're a really great team. So we're going to pull them in now.
I think they actually have perfect timing, Mr. Duncan. Like they came in right at the time that their group was next. So for Hammond High Magnet School, we have Alexander Batola, 32. Jonah Blades, 29. Liliana Bricotta, 30. Amaya Griffin, 28. Brandon Galota, 28. Addison Carmasol, 27. Benjamin Kern, 28. Jake Lane, 28. Cadence Lanier, 30. Christina Lee, 33. Amelia Mackey, 30. Nicholas Massa, 30. Jonathan McVeigh, 29. Dixit Moore, 29. Angelica Wynn, 28. Avery Pritchard, 30. Lainey Saragusa, 28. Linus Summerfield, 33. Jessica Verdon, 27. And Andrew Wilson, 27. As they go back to their seats, again, I want to thank the families and the faculty and staff and fellows who are here. I want you to know most of these students are not through taking the ACT exam. Like, this was their score the last time it was officially reported. Some may have taken it since then. And it also, besides the financial part, it benefits our schools as part of our accountability score. So we thank these students for their dedication and work towards that and support of their school. And thank you, families.
So guys, we are going to take that promised break, but we did have one more recognition for Mr. Vining, if you'll come on up.
Coach Taylor and Dr. Caminita, would y'all come forward, please? With the incredible 2 years that Ponchatoula's program, basketball programs have, they've also produced Mr. Louisiana basketball and all Gatorade basketball player as well. And I'd like to recognize Alan Grazer at this time. Come forward. Now. Alan, I think you're going to Santa Clara, is that correct? Santa Clara, so he is going just a few miles away. If you're not familiar with Santa Clara, that's California. So, I had to look it up, anyway. But they have an amazing program out there, and it had to be an amazing program to attract this young gentleman from this area. We would have loved to him to stay in local so we could go visit. So if you're ever out in California during the basketball season, feel free to go by and see him. He'd be glad to see y'all.
So that wraps up our awards and recognitions. I'm going to give you 5 minutes to get out if you want to get out. Otherwise, you got to stay for the rest of the meeting.
Channel 17, proudly serving the Florida parishes.
Next item on the agenda is to consider committee reports. We only have one report from our Finance and Audit Committee from April the 9th, 2024. Is there a motion to adopt the report?
So move.
Motion is made by Mr. Piazza.
Second.
Seconded by Mr. Anthony.
Brett, before we go any further on that one,
yep.
Is it okay? I speak?
Yep.
I know that, where did we leave off with, why am I drawing a blank, with the My People 123? I know he gave us his presentation. What's the next step on that one?
Yeah, so I actually talked to Mr. Lichardi after that meeting. I'm gonna try to set something up with Mr. McNeely. And we're gonna try to see how we can meld in his program with some of the other stuff that we're doing for grievance procedures, and then hopefully bring that back to the board.
Got it.
Yeah. All right, any other discussion on the motion? I don't have any public input on the motion. We'll call the question, ask members to vote your devices.
Voting is open.
Say that we're gonna vote our devices. Maybe not. Maybe I should join the meeting first.
I know mine rebooted.
Voting is closed. Motion passes unanimously.
Right. Next item under board actions is to consider approval for the low bid for our 2024 timber sale. The administration's recommending the sale of, well, Mr. McNeely, go ahead.
You can handle it. I'm just here in case you have a question that I can't answer.
We have it by Donahue Timber was the winning bidder.
Sole bidder, and that's the recommendation for Mr. Coxon to accept that bid.
Motion to adopt.
All right, motion is made by Mr. Westmoreland to adopt the administration's recommendation, seconded by Mr. Piazza. Any other discussion on the motion?
Question on that.
Question, Mr. Toller.
Actually, worse now. Look.
Jeff, I'll be light with it. Of course, not having anything to compare it to,
did, I'm assuming he compared this to other purchases, maybe it's just a going trend? I know timber sales right now are not that great.
I think we were glad to get a bid.
Okay, that's kind of what I thought.
Any other?
You can't argue. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Any other discussion on the motion? Hearing none, there's no public input. We'll call the question, ask members to vote your devices.
Voting is open. Voting is closed. Motion passes unanimously.
All right. Next up is personal privilege or board member comments. Before we do that, I do want to bring to the board's attention that at your desk today, you should have found a manila envelope. The manila envelope is the superintendent's evaluation document. If you have any questions about that document, I believe Ms. Fussell, is that your department to human resources and all of that stuff?
Mr. Jinko,
who is it? We're going to handle. Okay, if you have questions, if you have questions about the instrument itself, Mr. Jinko will be available to answer that. The procedure for this is outlined in our board policy and procedure manual. You'll have 30 days to return your completed evaluation to me. The evaluation comes directly to me. I will compile those results. We'll then have a meeting. At our next regular board meeting, we'll have an opportunity to discuss it as a board. After that discussion, you'll have an opportunity to change your scoring. Yes?
Did I put the dates correctly on the letter?
Oh, I don't know.
I said May 7th.
Well, you have 30 days to get the results to me for tabulation. May 7th, I guess, will be the meeting where we will meet to discuss as a board. You'll have an opportunity, if you want to change your score after that meeting. And then at the regular board meeting on May the
21st.
21st will be where we'll review the evaluation, the results of the evaluation with Ms. Stille. Okay? I think I have all of that right. If I have any portion of that wrong, then I'll fix it beforehand. Okay, but I think that's the general way that process works. All right, moving on then to the remaining board member comments. We'll start with Mr. Anthony.
I'll yield mine today, thank you.
All right, Ms. Abrams.
Just congratulations to all of our students tonight for going beyond their call of duty in school. And congratulations to the Ponchatoula Strawberry Festival for an amazing weekend. They did a great job. No activities that I know of or that I heard of. A couple of medical situations, but other than that, with that many people in the town of Ponchatoula, city of Ponchatoula, they had a great turnout. Mm-hmm. Congratulations.
Mr. Piazza.
Make it short and quick. Tonight was amazing because we did something unique that a lot of people don't realize. We had not only athletics, we had the band, and we had our academic scholars all in the same room being recognized at the same time. That is probably the biggest achievement we could probably ever imagine here on the board, because they go hand in hand. I know a lot of times football overshadows or a sport overshadows at a particular school, but we have band that also is just as key on a Friday night or a Wednesday night or whatever sporting event. And then you have our academics, where we have wonderful scholars that have shined above and beyond with their ACT scores. Because I think as a board member, every time somebody asks me about being a public school, you know, Stewart, we always hear, well, the private's got more ACT scores than we do. Well, guess what? That list was very long tonight, and I'm very proud of our scholars that we have in our school system. So I want to thank all of them guys for their hard work and all of their parents who stood behind them in them tiresome hours and pushed them to be better in their households. Again, to echo what Robin said about our Strawberry Festival, it was a wonderful festival. I think a lot of our nonprofits got a good funding boost, which is amazing because they put back into our community. And thank y'all.
All
And say DC Reeves should have made a lot on their turkey legs after the post that went viral about the $25 turkey legs.
And I saw the Italian festival booth over there selling,
they sure did.
Selling buffaloes.
A lot of an Italian
stuff. I saw y'all trying to sneak in on the strawberry festival. I see it.
All right, Mr. Moore.
yes, I want to commend all of our award winners tonight. It takes a neighborhood to raise a child. It takes a team to raise a champion, and it takes a successful school system to raise as many of those of our students who have achieved that high level of ATC score. So I want to say good job to our teachers, good job to our community.
All right, Mr. Westmore.
Yes, I'd like to also say thank you, students, for the great work you've done at Amead High in Ponchatoula, the indoor champion, the senior superlatives, the band students. I mean, all of these are all winners, and we appreciate them. If you hadn't seen the news yesterday on ESPN, one of our Amead High graduates, Mr. Devontae Smith, signed a little contract with Philadelphia Eagles. They renewed his contract for 3 years for $75 million.
Oh my goodness.
Guaranteed $51
million. Wow.
So take note, athletes, what can be done.
That's horrible.
You're related.
Amazing. Congratulations, Devontae Smith.
All right. And Miss Strawberry, Miss Dominguez.
Well, the Strawberry Festival, as I said, was a great success. And I'm still wearing strawberry. I'll wear strawberry for a little longer. I went from beginning to end every day. It was quite nice. We had no incidents. All of the nonprofits from Ponchatoula Schools I talked to, and they said they did really well. They made money, and all that money, as a reminder, goes back into our scholarships and our students and our community. It was great. The city of Ponchatoula hired Waste Management or Waste Pro to pick up the garbage, and they were it was clean. It looked like there was not a festival going on while it was going on. So it was quite amazing. It was a great year. Congratulations to the board for their hard work. I've been there many years, and it takes a lot of people to put that on and a lot of free hours that people volunteer to do. So appreciate that. I also wanted to, while I'm thinking about it, Ms. Fazell, we had a little student I want to recognize. Gavin Gill did not get recognized for a 28, so I just wanted to make sure he got a little kudos tonight. Also this past week I went to a legislative luncheon. It's called PAR, which is Public Affairs Research Council, and we had the Senate House Chair and the Representative House Chair, and we also had one of our representatives and another financial guy for the state, and they did a panel, and we talked, and we heard a lot of things. It's conflicting on the Senate and the House side about the future of education. And so tomorrow we have over 250 school board members going with the state to the conference, our LSBA Capitol Conference, and we're going to legislate for what's best for public education. So be aware, be cautious. If you're a person paying attention, there's a lot of changes coming. We need to be ready. So thank y'all for supporting us, and looking forward to tomorrow.
Okay. Mr. Toler.
Yeah, first and foremost, congratulations to all the students, the parents, the teachers, and the schools that accomplished everything that we recognize here tonight. That's huge for the academics and sports to come together like that. And I know it's not something that we take for granted, and I'm glad that we take time out of our meeting to recognize them. Secondly, I know earlier we were frustrated with conversations about our frustrations regarding schools, projects, and I think we all share those frustrations. They're all pointed probably in different directions maybe. This is something that I reached out to Ms. Dilley about this week, and I'm going to publicly read this list because I want to start bringing this, and I hope all of you will do the same thing, because publicly we need to let people know what we're advocating for. And like at Sumner Middle, we have an awning that's still down from Ida. rainy days, kids are sitting in the, standing in the rain waiting to either get off or get on the bus. We have a metal building there that I think 2 years ago Coach Fussell put a requisition in for football gear because we have no place to put football gear at the middle school. It's still not going on. There's picnic tables. Since we have no cafeteria, the kids eat in a gymatorium kind of thing, and they go outside, eat on picnic tables that are sitting on dirt. You can imagine what that dirt looks like when it rains or gets dew on it. It gets tracked back in our schools, besides the fact that it's not sanitary. We want to put concrete under those picnic tables. We have a need there for a band room. We have a need. We have parents that are pushing for band. We saw it tonight. We need a portable building for a band room. Over at Sumner High, the track is over 7 years old on that resurfacing. If we don't resurface it now, it has to be completely tore up and cost us twice as much in another 2 or 3 years. I know these are expensive things, but you have to be good stewards of money, and these are projects that we can't just put on the back shelf. We also have a plan wanting to put a road in with additional parking behind the football field, reaching out to the guard for that. Floors throughout the school, as you saw it at the meeting, the tiles, 20 years old, twice their lifespan, they need to be replaced. LED conversion lights on the inside of the school, which we probably can get grants for. Ceiling tiles, gym AC, and that's not even mentioning Chesbro with space. Phase two is putting a 5-classroom addition there. Roslyn Bardo has no room to put children for the next year. So those things are not debatable. We can argue to the court all we want to, but I would like them to come do, just put butts in seat and tell us, how do we make this happen? And then last but not least, Spring Creek, you know, we have a gym up there that was built in the 40s. It needs remodeling terribly. These needs should not be, and I don't address my frustration at the administration, although I do want to start sitting down with Melissa and go through this on maybe a monthly basis. These frustrations are shared through a lot of different issues, but we cannot put these needs on the back burner while we're still arguing with attorneys over what to do.
Amen.
These things have to continue, and we have to move forward. And I'm sure all of your schools, we have some big, and this is not a comprehensive list. This is just Tom's list on things I know of that we need to happen. So That's my soapbox for the night.
Amen.
Yeah, and I don't want to get reworked up, but you almost got me reworked up because I finally calmed
down. Go ahead, brother.
But no, I mean, because it's just, you know, that's just a small taste, and it's all throughout the parish. And time again, when we as board members that know our schools, know our community, go and we ask for these things to be addressed, we're told one of two things over and over. Either we have to wait because of something else, or we don't have the money for it. And a lot of times we don't have the money for it because we've been ordered to pay all these experts to come in and do more assessments, which not only does that take away money, it wastes time, it wastes all kinds of other resources, it wastes the attention of our administrators on things that we don't need them to be distracted by. And I think we're just all frustrated and tired of it. And
it's getting hard to answer those parents' questions. Yeah,
and we've done so much work, so much good work to address legitimate concerns that this court case has brought to our attention over the last, you know, 15 to 20 years, but it's time. It's time. All right. There was something else I was going to talk about, and Tom got me off.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. But thank you for that, Tom. All right. Oh yeah. The other thing I was going to talk about on the positive side, you know, I would just want to remind the community and the board that the recognitions that we got to participate in tonight, they are just a small taste of all of the awards and recognitions that will be taking place over the course of the next few weeks as we get closer and closer to graduation and the end of the school year. And it is just always so gratifying to see all of the results, the fruit of all of the work that this system does for our community, for our children, for the families in our community. And it's just a reminder when we hear folks at the state legislature or other folks in the community that try to claim that public education is failing our communities. You know, this is the data that we need to demonstrate that our school systems are not failing. We do a tremendous amount of great work. We prepare students for life, and the students that actually come to school every day, the students that actually do the work, stay out of trouble, the families that support the work that their students are doing, they can achieve fantastic results and be ready for college, be ready for careers, be ready for life if they just take advantage of all of the things that this school system makes available to them and the school systems throughout our state. So I would just ask all of us to just reject the lie that public education is failing our state, and that we need some sort of crazy, dramatic new scheme to come in and divert dollars away from our school system. That is not what needs to happen. And again, the stuff that we saw tonight is evidence of that. So, all right, so that was my little soapbox. All right, finally, I will receive a motion at this time to enter executive session to consider the case of Dawn Colbreth. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Motion is made by Mr. Westmoreland, seconded by Mr. Piazza. Without objection, the motion is agreed to and will enter executive session at this time.
Channel 17, proudly serving the Florida parishes.
I'll call the meeting back to order on the matter of Dawn Colbreth versus Tangipahoa Parish School System. I'll receive a motion at this time to adopt council's recommendation.
Motion to adopt.
Motion is made by Mr. Westmoreland. Is there a second?
Second.
Seconded by Ms. Dominguez. Any objection to the motion? Hearing no objection, the motion is agreed to. There being no other business to come before the board, this meeting is adjourned.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangilawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.